Sohan, welcome to ODSC India. Pleasure to have you here.
Thank you so much. My pleasure.
Now, Sohan, you just gave a talk here at ODSC India. I was part of the audience myself, a very packed room. So please do tell us a little bit about yourself and a little bit about your talk.
Sure. So my name is Sohan. I work in Amazon in the Alexa team as a developer evangelist. Right. So I spoke a little bit today about the machine learning and the data science that goes into Alexa. Right. Alexa is at the forefront of voice tech right now. There's a lot of speech to text, there's a lot of natural language understanding, there's a lot of text to speech. All of this involves a lot of machine learning, a lot of data science. So that was the focus of my talk today.
Yeah, and Amazon Alexa, as many people know, extremely impressive product. I remember the first time I brought one home, plugged it in, I spoke to it, understood my Irish accent, and amazingly, it understood my daughter's seven-year-old accent at the time, and that was very impressive. So what are the breakthroughs in the last couple of years that enabled these models where instead of training them for long periods of time and training your voice, all of a sudden now you can just go straight into giving them voice commands?
Yeah, so two things. One is I think the general speech to text has gotten so much better. In fact, I remember reading a report saying we're almost or nearly as good as any human, right? Which is like a 95-96% of speech to text conversion. And a lot of small improvements have happened on the natural language understanding front as well, right? And because we have access to so much more data right now, we're able to process it and, you know, hold context and things like that. And it's really improved. And we've had a lot of good talks today about how, you know, just small changes in, like, say, a data set or representing certain ways of what a user is saying has led to so much of an increase in, you know, conversions and speech to text improvements. So those are the
excellent. Great. And for someone interested in this area, what are some of the models they should be looking at, machine learning or deep learning models you recommend that they take a look at and study?
Yeah, so I'd say it depends on what they're really interested in. There's a lot of, so I spoke a little bit about this thing called a hypothesis re-ranker, right? Which is how the best skill is chosen for what a user is saying, which uses like a recurrent neural network and bi-directional LSTMs, right? So if they're interested in that, maybe that's the way to go. There's a lot of things that happen in the speech front as well, right? Where like let's take India, for example, there's just so many different accents and dialects and ways to represent things. So there's a lot of advancements that's happened in speech recognition. And one thing I'd personally like people to really do is maybe pick Indian languages and, you know, natural language understanding in Indian languages, because that's something that's not been explored too much, but I think has a lot of potential to change billions of lives. So.
Oh, excellent. And what are some of the other interesting areas of text analytics or NLP research that you are coming that are coming to the forefront right now at the moment?
Let's see now. So one, what I spoke about earlier is the Indian language support. Like, you know, India is a fairly large country and not everyone speaks English. There's just so many different languages. So the first step is a lot of people speak English with words from their native tongue thrown in. So that is like a challenge in itself. And second is conversing in like a Hindi or a Kannada, for example, right? Unfortunately, Indians have started coming online and very recently. So there's not that much data available for like NLP in these languages, but now they are. Right, so there is access to the data, so, you know, there's a lot of advancements. I know a lot of universities and academies are working on this, so would really like to see some sort of innovation in this space.
Oh, excellent. And you mentioned the LSTM models, like the idea of these models having a memory, but how far away do you think we are from moving away from question and answer platforms to true dialogue systems? So when I ask Alexa, what's the weather? It tells me it's raining. Then I ask it, should I bring an umbrella or not? Will it know the answer? Big
yeah,
ask.
True. Yeah, and bit of what I spoke today about was, you know, how changing how we represent what the user said helps in like these sort of contextual answers, right? Where if I say something like, find me a restaurant near the cricket game, it's very difficult because you have to sort of relate two different intents. But now with like the Alexa meaning representation language, which is something that we're working on, it becomes easier to sort of represent this interaction. So hopefully that will help with, you know, contextual things like what you said.
Yeah, context is going to be very, very exciting and still to come. So people who are interested in doing NLP, machine learning around that, what are some of the tools, platforms? Alexa's got an API, I know that you'd recommend.
Okay, so I work more on the Alexa side of things. So to be honest, I'm not too sure about the, you know, the machine learning parts of things, but we have an open API and an open SDK. We have like a bunch of templates for skills that you can build as well. So I just say, you know, explore some of that stuff. again, I'm not too sure on the other side of things. So
worries. And I want to ask you about how your ODSC India experience has been so far, but you were on the selection committee, so
yeah, I was.
Please tell us more.
Yeah, so to be honest, I work as an evangelist, so I do a lot of conferences. This is one conference that I know is purely about providing value to the attendees, right? It's not about the money, it's not about the sponsors, it's not about any of that stuff, in the sense that I was part of the committee. Every talk was chosen democratically based on the sort of value it would provide to the people attending, which I think is fantastic. Not too many other conferences do that. And ODSC did that really, really well. And you know, I was really touched and I was really inspired by how they approached it. And so far, it's been amazing. I met some great people. So really looking forward to
it. Yeah, well, great talk. Great job on the selection committee, and to you and everyone else who helped organize ODSC. So thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Sheamus. Thank you.